Hello, Stat 500. In this video, we're going to walk through an example of conducting a one sample proportion z-test. I'll show you how to do this using hand calculations and also using Minitab. Here's our research question. Do more than half of all World Campus students own a dog? At the beginning of the summer 2016 semester, a sample of 440 World Campus students were surveyed and asked if they own a dog. In that sample, 259 said that they do own a dog. From this scenario, we can see that n equals 440, and we can compute p hat, our sample proportion, to be 259 divided by 440, which equals 0.5886. The first thing that we're going to do is determine whether or not we can use the normal approximation method. Recall from your online notes that in order to use the normal approximation method, n times p and n times 1 minus p must be sufficiently large. There are different definitions of sufficiently large. I tend to use a cutoff of 10. So if n times p and n times 1 minus p are at least 10, then I would use the normal approximation method. Some sources will tell you that you can go as low as 5. Others will be more conservative and say that you need at least 15. In this case, both n times p and n times 1 minus p both equal 220. Regardless of what standard you're using, it is appropriate to use the normal approximation method for this scenario. So we're going to go ahead and conduct a one sample proportion z-test. Step 1, state hypotheses. Recall our research question, do more than half of all World Campus students own a dog? Personally, I like to start with the alternative hypothesis. So the research question is, do more than half own a dog? So our alternative hypothesis is going to be that the population proportion is greater than 0.5. This leaves our null hypothesis to be that the population proportion equals 0.5. Step 2, select alpha level. In our scenario, the alpha level was not given to us. Unless you're in a situation where making a type 1 error could have greater consequences, you typically use an alpha level of 0.05. Step 3, compute the test statistic. This is our formula for the z-test statistic. In the numerator, we have the difference between the sample proportion and the hypothesized population proportion. The denominator should look familiar from the last lesson. This is the standard error. Recall from our scenario, we were given that n equals 440. We computed a sample proportion, or p hat, of 0.5886. And from the research question, we found that the hypothesized population proportion is 0.5. We can plug all of these values into this formula, and we find a z-test statistic of 3.7170. What this is essentially doing is creating a normal distribution with a mean of 0.5 and a standard deviation of 0.0238 and computing a z-score. We'll use this z-score in the next step. Step 4, construct rejection region or compute p-value. I'll show you how to do this both ways. First, let's use the rejection region approach. Recall, our alternative hypothesis was that the population proportion is greater than 0.5. This tells us that we're going to have a right-tailed test. In step 2, we said that we were going to use an alpha level of 0.05. So our rejection region is going to be the right of the z-score that separates the top 5% from the bottom 95%. Here, I used Minitab Express to construct a normal distribution with a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. To find the z-score that separates the top 5% from the bottom 95%. This is sometimes known as the critical value. So our critical value in this case is positive 1.64485. If our z-test statistic, which we actually computed in the last step, is greater than this value, then we would reject the null hypothesis. If our z-test statistic is less than this value, then we fail to reject the null hypothesis. In the last step, we computed a z-test statistic of 3.7170. This does fall within our rejection region, So step five, make a decision. We're going to reject the null hypothesis. Because our z-test statistic fell within our rejection region, we reject the null hypothesis. Let's go back to step four now, and I'll show you how to do this using the p-value approach as well. Using the p-value approach, we're going to take the z-score that we computed in step three and map that onto the normal distribution and determine the probability of having a z-score greater than that value, because again, this is a right-tailed test. So we take our z-test statistic of 3.7170, and our alternative hypothesis was that p is greater than 0.50, so this is a right-tailed test. We're interested in looking up the proportion that is greater than a z-score of 3.7170. And that is our p-value. So our p-value for this test is 0.0001008. And the interpretation of this value would be, if the null hypothesis was true, so if the population proportion really was 0.50, the probability that we would take a random sample of 440 World Campus students and find a sample proportion of 0.5886 or higher due to random sampling error is 0.0001008. Thus, we would conclude that the difference that we observed in our sample is likely due to an actual difference between the populations. We could compare this p-value to our alpha level of 0.05. Because p is less than 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. Regardless of whether you use the rejection region approach or the p-value approach, your decision should be the same every time. Step six, state conclusion. Recall our original research question, do more than half of all World Campus students own a dog? Our null hypothesis was that the population proportion equals 0.5. The alternative hypothesis is that the population proportion was greater than 0.5. We did both the rejection region and the p-value approach. In both cases, reject the null hypothesis. Our conclusion is that there is evidence that more than half of all World Campus students own a dog. Now I'll show you how you can do this procedure using Minitab. In Minitab, steps one and two are going to be the same. So in step one, you're going to have to write out your hypotheses. You'll have to determine whether you have a two-tailed hypothesis, a right-tailed, or a left-tailed hypothesis test. In step two, you're going to have to determine the alpha level. Steps three and four, though, we'll compute using Minitab. In Minitab, we'll go to Stat, Basic Statistics, One Proportion. We're going to enter in summarized data. Recall from our scenario that 259 out of 440 owned a dog. We do want to perform a hypothesis test. The hypothesized proportion value was 0.5. Under options, there's a few things that we'll have to change. Our alternative hypothesis was that the population proportion is greater than 0.5. Additionally, we checked the assumptions to use the normal approximation method. Here's our Minitab output. We can see that Minitab computed our sample proportion, a one-sided confidence interval, a z-test statistic of 3.72, and a p-value. While Minitab lists the p-value as being 0.000, we would typically write this as p is less than 0.001. Because this p-value is less than 0.05, in step 5, we would reject the null hypothesis, and in step 6, our conclusion would be that there is evidence that the population proportion is greater than 0.5.